Adam Waugh's with me from BlueRock Diamonds here in the studio. Adam, nice to see you. Welcome along.
Indeed, thank you.
Give us a bit of an introduction here to BlueRock Diamonds. You've got a producing asset in South Africa.
That's right, yeah. We have a 3,000 hectare mining right in the Kimberley area of South Africa. The mining right's about 120 kilometres north of Kimberley. And on that mining right, we have five known kimberlite pipes, of which we're mining one of those kimberlite pipes at this stage.
And how much are you producing at the moment?
We're producing around 600 to 650 carats a month. Our target is to produce more than that.
And for you, it's about quality, it's not quantity, right? That's the key.
Yeah, it is. We will never be a large producer. We are, as given the asset that we currently have, we won't be producing significant quantities of diamonds. The very exciting thing about Kareevlei, which is the mining area that we have, is the quality of the diamonds. In fact, we sit in the top 10 in the world of dollar per carat for kimberlite diamonds, which is mined diamonds. And our average dollar per carat for diamonds at the moment is running at about $340 a carat,
right.
Which, as I say, sits us in the top 10 of the world. So we have a very high quality product, and we have of the run-of-mine diamonds that come out of the ground, 85% are gem quality.
Well, just building on that, what are the development plans here for the project?
Okay, so we're mining, of the five pipes, we're mining what we call K2, which is one of the pipes. And we're about 2 years into that project, and we have a further 5 to 7 years life of mine in K2.
Right.
Of the other four pipes, we know quite a lot about two of them. Having done quite a lot of drill analysis on those other two pipes, we're likely to be mining one of those during the first quarter of next year at the same time as the current pipe we're mining. We're also doing some bulk sampling work of the least known of our five pipes, which is pipe five. We'll be doing that over the course of the next month or two, perhaps in the next month, more likely in 2 months. We know very little about that pipe. It is the smallest of our pipes. However, this very limited work that was done on it before suggests the coarseness of the diamonds is higher than the other pipes, i.e. the pipe will carry larger diamonds than the other pipes. So we're excited about that.
And as you say, it's a great part of the world to be in. There's been some pretty big discoveries there in the past.
Yeah, I mean, Kimberley gives its name to kimberlites, and kimberlites are all over the world or in the diamond areas of the world. Within the Kimberley area, there are, it's fair to say, hundreds of kimberlite pipes, not all are diamondiferous. However, perhaps the most famous is right in the middle of Kimberley, which is the Big Hole, which was the grandfather of all kimberlites mined in the late 19th century.
And you live there as well?
Yeah, I live in Kimberley, yeah. Yeah, and I have been for a year and a half and thoroughly enjoy it.
And how long have you been with BlueRock Diamonds?
I started as an advisor to the company back in November 2015, and I started as my current role as chief executive in May 2016.
Aside from this flagship project here, you've got another project on the go at the moment?
Yeah, we are specifically interested in kimberlite diamond mining as opposed to alluvial diamond mining, and we get plenty of options to look at known kimberlites. We're currently doing some sampling work on another kimberlite that we have an option on, and that's not too far away from our existing plant. So we'll do further bulk sampling on that and make a decision as to whether that's a mineable asset or not. We also, as I say, get shown, given that we're a producer and we have good expertise in that part of South Africa, we are shown quite a lot of other opportunities, and we're continuing to assess other kimberlites.
In South Africa?
Yeah, in South Africa. Ideally, they will be in the Kimberley area. However, we don't restrict ourselves to that. We will look at things. It's unlikely we'll go outside of Southern Africa, but we will look at other things in the Southern African region.
And you're looking at some potentials at the moment?
Yeah, I mean, we're always looking at potentials. We've got a very strong team in Kimberley that pretty much all of them have got De Beers experience in their CVs at one stage or another. Some have been in the diamond industry for 30 or 40 years and know quite a lot about some of the discovered but unmined pipes in that area. And we're being shown quite a lot of potentials, and we have a very high quality control. We're all about quality in terms of where we're mining at the moment. We don't mind looking in relatively low grade mines as long as the quality and the dollar per carat is very high. So we will stick to that as a strategy going forward.
And you've recently had a tender. Were you pretty pleased with how that went?
Yeah, we were very pleased with the recent tender. We sell our diamonds at tender monthly. We sold our highest caratage in the October tender, which was 611 carats, and we achieved $371 a carat for that, which is a good bit above our average for this year so far, which is running at about $334. And again, it just gives more evidence of the really good quality of diamonds that come out of the ground. And as our production is increasing, the number of buyers looking at our product at tender is increasing. And we're starting to get, even though we're a small producer, we're starting to get an international recognition for the quality of our stones.
That's interesting. I was going to ask you that. So you are getting quite significant interest here.
Yeah, we are. And I think the other thing that's worth remembering is that for example, in that parcel that we sold in the October tender, the single largest stone in that parcel was 5.5 carats. So we're not reliant on huge diamonds to generate that $370 per carat. This is anything from a very small diamond up to a 5.5 carat diamond, which is giving us a very good average dollar per carat.
Tell me a little bit more about your shareholder base, predominantly retail?
Yeah, I'd say we've probably got about 50% of the shareholder base that would be retail and about 50% of the shareholder base that would primarily be original founders.
Right, well look, we're pretty much at November now. 2017 nearly done. 2018, pretty busy for you. You're looking at just the development options here for your flagship project.
Yeah, I think it's consolidating on the improvements we've made this year so far with production. Our production numbers have been gradually improving month on month, so we want to consolidate on that. As I mentioned before, we're currently mining one of our pipes. We will be looking to expand the operation to mine one of the other nearby pipes
next year,
probably in the first quarter of next year,
right.
And that will be all processed through the existing plant that we have. So yeah, we'll be. And also that pipe does carry a slightly higher grade than the current pipe that we're mining. So we're certainly very much looking forward to that. Plus that sampling work we're doing on that small pipe that we haven't yet, that we don't know very much about.
Lots to look forward to. Adam, good to meet you. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Thanks.